Hey guys, welcome back to a brand new video. Today's video is going to be a collaboration with my friend Sarah. She is a dear friend. I absolutely adore her. And I'm going to share her video down below. This is why I left the TEASQUAD. And the TEASQUAD, as you know, is the Here for the Tea, like, family. And I have spoken out like against Here for the Tea in like some other videos, but this is just one video, everything in there, like why I stopped supporting Sam. And, you know, you guys can give me your opinions on it. I understand a lot of people still support her and love her. I totally get that. I don't hate her by any means. I just want to, you know, tell you guys why I stopped wanting to be a part of the TEASQUAD. So when I first saw Here for the Tea, it was back around the time she had put out that Kat Von D video. And I really liked her bluntness. I liked her content. I liked her editing. I liked her voice. And the only thing that bothered me about that Kat Von D video was her going all into this like plastic surgery that Kat had. And I just felt like that was unnecessary. But she always came for the beauty gurus. She was always exposing people that were not disclosing sponsorships, affiliate links, discount codes. You know, without Here for the Tea, I don't know that we would have even, at least at that time, known a lot about the shady type of behavior from the beauty community. She was exposing everybody, you know, especially like Jaclyn Hill. And I really liked her. She would do You Now streams and I'd pop in there. We've DM'd a couple times. We talked in her You Now. I remember one time I was actually at a sports bar, but I had my earbuds in and I was on You Now because like everybody was watching a game and I was like, I'm just going to be in here talking to her. Every interaction I had with her was good. There was a point in time where there was like a lot of drama going on with Petty Page and Margot Indigo, and I love both of them. Now, I didn't know the full story, but I saw a video by a young creator, not sure the name of the person, and I left a comment saying, I'm tired of defending Sam. She's just flat out mean at times, you know? There's a difference between like being blunt and open and honest and like being like, get the fuck out of my stream, and you know, just how she is. So I left a comment, which wasn't mean, it was just like, I'm just tired of defending her because, you know, this whole calling Petty Page Peppa Pig thing really, really got on my nerves. So she ended up messaging me. She DM'd me on Twitter and was like, is this you? And at the time, my sister sometimes used my account, my YouTube account before she got her own. So I was like, what, you know, I couldn't see like the screenshot. So when I went online, I could see it. And I was like, yeah, that's me, you know? And, you know, it's sort of like, oh, I was explaining myself, like, you know, I really didn't have a lot of information about what went on with all of you guys. And I just, you know, was sort of not feeling it. Like, I apologize, but that's how I was feeling at the time. She said, oh, there's so much more to that situation you don't even know. And really, at that time, I was actually like a little intimidated by her. Not just by her, but as she grew and people became these huge stans and like this cult following with her, they were so brutal to anybody and everybody that she didn't like, she didn't agree with. I even became one of those people because she did a video where she just so happened to include a screenshot of this MUA like begging for PR. And I even went on Twitter and called him a bad name because of it. Like, and I'm like, I don't even know this person. And you know that she left that in there so people would go and attack him. And that's what happened. And there's like these little subtle things, you know, and she can always like not take responsibility for others' actions and say, well, I didn't tell them to go do anything. But when you put it out there, you kind of are, you know? And I was just really sick of the way that she treated people, the way that she talked about people. And really what happened for me is, I mean, I don't know that there was one particular breaking point. It was a culmination of like all of these things. The way that her like hardcore fans and her would talk about people, the way that they behaved in You Now, the subtweeting, my God, the subtweeting. And it was just too much. Then there was always a Jeffree Star video. I really started to kind of see her for being, when she tweeted about Jeffree Star's body and like calling him anorexic and malnourished and stuff, that's when I think it showed her true character. Even 17, like Magazine Online, like picked that up. And then it was even more Jeffree Star videos. There was a whole December where every video was Jeffree Star. December, as you guys know, is a big, like the biggest month to get like ad money. So people want to upload as much as they can. And it was always about Jeffree Star, even when it wasn't drama, you know? So a little bit before that happened, I would leave comments on her videos that I liked. And, but I would be outspoken about her when I didn't agree with her, or when I thought that she was just being petty, or I thought that she just kept going after Jeffree because she had nothing else to do. And I'll get to that in a little bit. So after all these Jeffree Star videos, it was just too much. And I think that when she started becoming friends with these beauty influencers, there's no problem with her being friends with Manny or being friends with Jackie Aina or friends with Jaclyn Hill, even though she used to tear Jaclyn Hill apart, and for good reason. The problem is that the content changed. No longer was she exposing people. No longer was she covering all the drama. Like, she didn't cover a lot with like Thomas Helbert because at the time she was friends with him. She wouldn't cover Manny because she's friends with him. I mean, look at all of the drama that has happened in the last year that she didn't cover. Jackie Aina and Petty Page, that was huge. She, you know, she said some things in like You Now and stuff, but she didn't make a video on anything that was going on unless it was Jeffree Star related. And I think that alienated a lot of her audience because it was boring as shit. Like, who cares? You know, we know you don't like him, but you're making a video about a possible tweet to a fan that maybe somebody could take the wrong way if you put it in a different context. Like, that's not drama, you know? And all of these things were going on, you know, Jackie Aina and Petty Page and Thomas Helbert. When Manny did his video with his dad, the first one, and was sponsored by BetterHelp, you know what I mean? There were so many things going on, and she was so good and talented at her content that people wanted to know, like, what she felt. People wanted videos on the drama because she was the drama channel, you know? And I like I said, I don't care that she's friends with these people, but her content is very biased now when she does upload. And the thing about that is she could be on a break from YouTube for however long. And if somebody like brings up something or there's some subtweets going on, I mean, there's all sorts of drama on Twitter. People will be like, oh, leave Sam alone. She's going through a lot of things. Like, this is personal, just leave her alone, you know, she's going through these issues and stuff, and being very vague about that, and I understand, but they didn't care when they were bullying people, and they were going through things, but they want to protect her, and it's like, they will do her dirty work for her, these hardcore fans. I don't understand it. I don't understand how you can blindly follow somebody like that. Now, even when I liked her, when she did stuff that I didn't like, I would say so. When she had content that I liked, I would say so. So when Jackie Aina put her video out on Petty Page, it was a complete lie, calling her a thief. Because it was about a week before then when, or maybe it was even a few days, when Here for the Tea tweeted, like, what would you guys think if I did a collaboration with a beauty influencer? And so when Jackie came out with that video, I was just joking, but I tweeted, I guess we got the Here for the Tea and beauty influencer, like, collab, LOL. So I wasn't on Twitter for a while after that, and I had to have people send me screenshots of the things that she said. Nobody really attacked me, like, hardcore, there were some people that like DM'd me like some mean shit, like, you're just a fat bitch or whatever. Like, I care. And that's the thing. Like, you'll know that they are her hardcore fans because they will tear you apart. They will drag you to filth. And sometimes you can see it in the comments, you know? And just because you don't like somebody that they like worship, you know? So I said it as a joke, and then she got pissed and said, "Don't ever comment on my videos ever again." Ah, you know, and I'm just like, okay, you know, but there really hasn't been any videos since then, you know? But I respected her as her creator, even though I didn't like her. And I'm like, I should be able to say what I like and what I don't like, you know? And I feel like she gets people to bully other people. Like I said, do her dirty work for her. I don't know why. And she's always like, oh, like everybody's got to be ride or die for her. Like this crazy amount of loyalty. It's like nobody knows you in person, at least these people. And sure, it's great to have good friends that are gonna stick up for you and like have your back. But I could never have a friend that I just stood up for no matter what they did, even if they were wrong. I could be there for you, but I'm gonna tell you that you're wrong. You know what I mean? So having this sort of like cult following is just so weird to me. And I think at first when like you're like, I was a part of it and in the YouNow and everything, like in the streams and stuff like that, and she would talk to me here and there, it felt like we were part of this group, like almost like we were like the mean girls in a sense. And I don't know why that felt good, which is really fucking gross. But then it felt really bad because you would see this behavior, not just from her and her subtweets and the shit about Jeffree Star and her biased ass content, but you would see her hardcore fans attacking people, even though it was none of their business, even though it was something like personal between her and somebody. Somebody just said like one thing wrong, you know, critiqued her in any way. It's this huge deal. And she still goes off all the time. And I really don't like it. And I think that was pretty much the last thing. I was like, okay, well, I should be able to comment on whatever I want to comment on. And I would if there was any like good content or bad content or content that had nothing to do with Jeffree Star. I know she made like her big comeback or whatever. I thought it was very lackluster. It wasn't like something that I was excited about. And I think, like I said, it's okay to be friends with these people now because a lot of us feel like she always wanted to be a beauty influencer. There were moments when she would do on-camera videos and like have like a review, you know, I think it was a glam glow or something like that. So I think that it makes her feel important to be friends with these people that are just regular people that happen to review products. But when they do some fucked up shit and she doesn't do her job, you know, she's not either, she does a video not sharing all of the information so that she can have you guys like support the side that she does, or she doesn't talk about it at all. And that was very clear with that guy, with that dirty ass cell phone, with that whole Jeffree Star thing, that like hairdresser, that complete fucking loser guy, that just wanted some attention. Because he was always like, oh, well, if you subscribe or if I get this many likes, then I'll release this. For her to even entertain that shit was like, okay, like you've gone way too far. So yes, I miss her content that she used to have. I miss her really exposing the truth about these situations. And like I said, she's friends with a lot of these influencers. That's fine. But it changed your content. It changed how you acted, you know? And that's the thing, like, it's just, her shit's boring, and T-Spill is now, like, the drama queen, and I absolutely love her. She's a fucking sweetheart. I could not be more happy for her. And, you know, I'm disappointed. I am disappointed that I was part of, like, this group that basically were just a bunch of bullies. I remember calling that makeup artist, like, a cunt. When she had that screenshot, I don't know that I ever like attacked anybody, but other than that, but I did always stick up for her. I'm like, she's just blunt, like being an apologist on her behalf. Like, she's just blunt. Oh, that's just how she is. Like, I like blunt. I like that kind of stuff. I like somebody that's just straight up and honest, but it was too much. It was just getting mean, you know? And, I mean, and being like, oh, well, if you don't like her, then somebody's going to attack you, and having that intimidation right there shows a lot about like how her character is and the people that are really diehard fans of hers. There are a lot of people that like her content that find her, you know, to be in the wrong sometimes. They actually don't blindly follow her, which is great. But, you know, you just don't, I don't understand her appeal anymore. And, like I said, her content really changed, and it was really disappointing, to see her just continually go after Jeffrey for the smallest of things and not cover so much of the drama that ended up happening. And, you know, if she was going through things, I totally get that. But then in turn, her and her fans should get that when it comes to somebody else. And their constant harassing of Petty Page was probably the biggest thing. Because I love Petty Page. I think she's absolutely wonderful. And she didn't deserve that shit. You know what I mean? And there are a lot of people that used to be friends with Sam. And she would say, oh, you know, like all these... why is it that Jeffrey's losing all these friends? Like, the constant is Jeffrey, like back in the day when she did videos. But there's also a constant with her. You know, I don't doubt for one second that Peter Mon was a piece of shit friend, like she said, like one-sided friendship. But there are a lot of people that were really close to her that aren't anymore. And so you have to look at that too. There are friends of mine that she has sucked in that really love her now, but used to hate her when I liked her. And I'm like, just be careful. Like, I wouldn't trust her. You know what I mean? So I don't know. This is just my personal opinion. This is just how I feel. If you like Here for the Tea, I'm not saying that you're one of these hardcore bullying fans. And when I say bully, I'm not saying like criticizing somebody or, you know, even really telling somebody off. I'm talking about the people that continually harass certain people all the time, always posting mean shit for no reason. You know, that's the kind of stuff I'm talking about. I'm not saying all of her fans are bullies or anything, but that's why I left the TEASQUAD. I just was tired of defending somebody and apologizing for somebody that I doubt would do the same for any of you, you know, and her content and being really biased and calling Petty Page Peppa Pig. It's just bullshit. And those are my reasons. Like I said, I'm going to link Sarah's video down below. I hope that you enjoy her content and subscribe to her. She is absolutely wonderful. And thanks for watching. Subscribe if you want to. And I will leave my Twitter down below if you want to follow me on Twitter or just tweet mean things at me for this video. I'll see you guys soon. Love and hugs. Bye.